Weighing in at over 6,600 pounds, 0-60 in 2.5 seconds, cladded in tank-like space-grade steel, and a body full of hard edges makes a Cybertruck ready for the impending apocalypse. But as a kid hauler and grocery getter, is the Cybertruck actually a threat to society? Safety experts are horrified from what they are seeing. We have a public safety concern here with the Cybertruck, and make sure to stay to the end because what we're going to do is talk about the Cybertruck, its structure, what experts are talking about. We're going to break down this article from Reuters to actually find out if the Cybertruck is a menace to society or not. If you want to see more Tesla content on the channel, smash a like button. If you don't, comment down below why. And let's get into this article from Reuters. This topic's been in my queue for a few days now, and this is still the top article over at Reuters. So it must be doing well for them. They're not ready to bump this off of their front page of their autos and transportation section. So this must be a very hot topic, and that's why we're going to weigh in on it. Reuters spoke to 6 safety professors and officials who viewed videos of the crash test conducted by Tesla on its first new vehicle in nearly 4 years and shown during a webcast delivery event last week. Let's check out this Cybertruck test. Well, it did really well on the rollover test. That doesn't come as a surprise since the center of gravity is really low on a battery electric vehicle, despite this being a pickup truck. Okay, so here we are. Here's the front end crash test. Now, this is an immovable wall. This is worst case scenario. It's going 35 miles an hour, and let's see what's going on. You know, a lot of people like to say Tesla didn't engineer this for safety. They kind of dropped the ball on it. Well, at least for the passengers, it doesn't look great. I mean, this guy's surely smashing his head into the back of the front seat. It's got airbags. The airbags are doing what they should be doing there. And that glass is shattering. And if we look at this side impact, I think this is where Cybertruck is very impressive, holding up. We know it can take bullets. This space grade steel is going to be, I think it's going to be a very safe vehicle for the occupants. For everyone else around it, I'm not so sure. I mean, Musk has already gone on to say that this is going to win any other argument on the road if there is a confrontation, a physical confrontation. So, you know, a lot of people are also saying, hey, you know, this back wheel, well, here's the thing. This is not normal. You know, it does have 4-wheel steering. So the rear, I mean, the car's totaled anyways at this point. So what does it matter that the rear steering apparatus here on the back tire seems to be a little dislocated, to say the least. All right, here's Adrian Lund, former president of the Insurance Institute for the IIHS, whose vehicle crash tests are an industry standard. So here's a true, not an armchair, or what do you call it, a armchair expert or computer keyboard warrior. This is a legit safety guy. He says the big problem there is if they really make the skin of the vehicle very stiff by using thick stainless steel, then when people hit their heads on it, it's going to cause more damage to them. Here's the thing, Adrian. If you get hit by any car on the head going 35 miles an hour, you're going to die. So I don't see why. Yes, it's potentially more dangerous, but any other car is still going to kill you if you get hit in the head. So I'm not buying that one. Let me know what you guys have to say about that. Of course, Musk, he's like the world's greatest salesman, right? He said that he's highly confident that the Cybertruck will be safer than other trucks for occupants and pedestrians. I agree with him probably on the occupants, potentially, you know, unless like the battery gets somehow punctured and, you know, you have thermal runaway and they're caught inside. That's the thing. One of my safety concerns, how are people going to get saved from this vehicle? If it's in an accident, they can't open the doors because the glass is supposed to be pretty much shatterproof, but I think they've toned back on the toughness of the glass. You can't really pry open the doors because the steel's too strong. So jaws of life, that should be like a part of the safety testing. Jaws of life, how are they able to get people out of these vehicles? That's my safety concern for the Cybertruck's occupants. But assuming you're not trapped on the inside and there's no fire from the battery or something, I think it is going to be pretty safe. Pedestrians, though, you know, why would this be safer for pedestrians? We already talked about how this is more rigid, more angular, more dangerous potentially for hitting pedestrians. But here's why it's safer. Well, Tesla has great software, and in theory, its software and it's fairly autonomous driving should be able to recognize people on their cameras and sensors and be able to bring the vehicle to a stop. So I do believe it could be potentially safer for pedestrians if the software is as good as it should be. If we look at this comment on Elon Musk's post from Whole Mars Catalog, he's saying the Cybertruck dangerous for pedestrians is BS. Take a look at the F-150 Cybertruck side by side. This is the Haggerty video. The wall of a truck will take a pedestrian out quick. Cybertruck slow front and AI active safety are way safer than traditional trucks. I'm not sure about that. Well, maybe this the AI part and the software, but the sloped front here, I think both are going to kill you just in different ways. This is more of like getting your lower body chopped off with this angular steel. And this is more like blunt force trauma that is going to destroy your internal organs. So you pick your death trap. They remind us that the last vehicle that had a stainless steel exterior was the DeLorean. Hopefully the Cybertruck has a longer track record than the DeLorean. The DeLorean, rest in peace. It's definitely a cult classic, but DeLorean was not a very reliable car. And I think the Cybertruck will be much more reliable. I like Musk putting the steel on the truck. I like the bulletproof like glass. He said the material is so strong that it's broken the stamping machines that form the panels. It's essentially bulletproof. It's hard to destroy. That's what you want in a rugged truck. And of course that helps with its, I think it helps with its safety impacts too, but you also have crumple zones. Of course, Tesla has crumple zones in this. It's built in. Some people are saying that it doesn't have enough crumple zones. If it passes the tests that it's required to here in North America, then what else could you ask for? And here's a little of my personal take on Tesla and their built-in safety. Now, this doesn't affect the Cybertruck, but it kind of does. I'll explain why. So in October, when I was at the Japan Mobility Show, I spent probably 30, 40 minutes talking to the gigacasting expert, the man in charge. I don't know his name off the top of my head, but we had a great talk about Toyota's success with gigacasting and how they will be using it with their next gen EV platform. And I asked him a lot of questions about Tesla. And he said, the thing about Tesla is that somehow they figured out how to gigacast crumple zones into their front gigacasted piece on the Model Y. Toyota hasn't figured that out yet. So Tesla has the best gigacasting technology and safety technology built into their models or built into their structures. And even though, as far as I'm aware, Cybertruck is not gigacasted, I could be wrong. I haven't seen it be produced yet. But Tesla understands safety, you could say, as well as anyone or better than anyone. So I'm not worried about the crumple zone argument out there. And the front and rear structures have energy-absorbing ribs that help dissipate energy. And during a side impact, the skin of the door carried a majority of the crash load. We saw that already. George Washington University, he's an auto safety professor. His name's Samer Hamdar, raised concerns about limited crumple zones, but added that other features might make up for that. Exactly. On to another expert, David Friedman, former acting head of the NHTSA, described the effect for the loser of the crash. If you're in a crash with another vehicle that has a crumple zone and your car is more stiff, then their cars are going to get crushed and yours is resistant. Maybe, but if these vehicles are both passing the same safety tests that the NHTSA is administering, or the IIHS is administering, then what's the point? It's done what it's needed to pass the regulations. Julia Griswold, director of Cal Berkeley's Safe Transportation Research and Education Center, said she was alarmed by the crash test videos Tesla posted. She said the heavy weight of the trucks and their high acceleration raise red flags for non-occupants. So let's talk about the weight thing. All right, I have up the Cybertruck weight. It weighs 6,600 pounds, roughly. All right, what about other fast expensive trucks, $100,000 trucks, because the Cybertruck is $100,000 in the beast form, or the cyber beast, roughly, right? So if we look at the Ford F-150 Raptor R, loved that truck. Watch my review on it. It was actually one of the... It's actually the fastest 0-60 I've done on my channel. I think it did it like in three and a half, something like that. And the Cybertruck does it in 2.5, which is just lunacy. So here you have it. You have the F-150 weighing in about 6,000 pounds, so 600 pounds less. You have the Ram TRX, haven't driven this one, but about 150 pounds less or so, but same ballpark as the Cybertruck. And then we also have the Hummer EV weighing in at 9,000 pounds. Has anyone talked about the safety of the Hummer? Probably. I'm sure people have. Tesla's more fun to talk about than General Motors. So that's why the buzz and the Cybertruck is far more interesting of a vehicle compared to the Hummer, in my opinion. I see one of these about once a week down here in Naples, and I'm just like, what are you doing? They're just going out to restaurants, or I think one guy who has one in my area is a contractor. So it's just, it's lifestyles of the rich and famous. R1T, 7,000 pounds. So the R1T is, no one's talking about the safety concerns with this vehicle that I'm aware of. So all pickup trucks, at least high performance, $100,000 pickup trucks, give or take a few thousand dollars, all of them are heavy. All of them are fast. So that's a moot point, in my opinion, using the weight against the Cybertruck. And using the acceleration against it is also, I think, not fair to the Cybertruck. Every pickup truck in America is big, fast, and heavy. It's not the truck's fault that potentially that it could be unsafe. In my opinion, it's more so the drivers. As long as you have the money, you can go buy yourself any of those pickup trucks, and it could be a huge safety hazard for anyone, depending on how you're driving it. Any pickup truck in America, if it gets in an accident with a smaller car, that's a safety hazard. But this is America. It's land of the free. We do what we want. We buy guns. We smoke a bunch of stuff. We drink a bunch of stuff that's not good for us. But that's a part of being human, and it's a part of freedom and free will. And buying in a big, fast, heavy, expensive pickup truck, regardless of what it's made out of, should be able to be done as long as you can cough up the money for it. And typically there are pretty good laws and measures in place that if you're an unsafe driver or you're a psychopath, you'll be either you get your license taken away, or there are consequences through the judicial system, maybe. What about the Cybertruck in Europe? They have different safety regulations than we do. So Tesla's not said whether it's going to sell in Europe. Tesla's chief engineer told motoring publication Top Gear that European safety rules aimed at protecting pedestrians by limited external protrusions could make it a tough sell there. The European Transport Safety Council said, "We hope Tesla don't bring this vehicle to Europe. The vehicle of this size, power, and weight will be lethal to pedestrians and cyclists in a collision." Any pickup, any car is lethal to a cyclist in a collision. I know there are different standards and tests, but guys, don't ride a bike in America is my recommendation, unless you just got big old ball. You people have the choice to drive a motorcycle. That's extraordinarily unsafe. Riding a bicycle is extraordinarily unsafe on the roads here in North America. I'm not buying that the Cybertruck is unsafe or is a safety hazard. And that's really the last piece I wanted to touch on this article. So you guys already have my opinion on the Cybertruck. I like the Cybertruck from my last video. I like it. I hate the design of it, but it is cool. I'll give it that. Probably my favorite thing is the stainless steel on it. And is it unsafe? Absolutely, it's unsafe, but so is every other massive vehicle out there. But you know what else is unsafe? Stepping out your door. All right. If you're worried about every little thing out there, you will eventually be killed by it. We're all going to die. And it's not going to be by a Cybertruck. More than likely, you're more likely to die from any other truck on the road, since there are far more of them and they're just as dangerous as the Cybertruck, assuming the Cybertruck is not losing traction when it's doing 0-60s on public streets. But most of them aren't. Most of the time when I see Tesla drivers, they're driving too slow for me, even though their cars are way faster in acceleration than most of the cars I test on the channel. So most Tesla drivers are just babying their vehicles, even though they're packing a lot of acceleration. And that's why I'd expect also for the Cybertruck. You know, it's not fun to do 0 to 60s regularly. It's a lot of stress on the body. It's a lot of G-forces. You can get car sick, and it's also dangerous. So if you have an open road and no one's around you, yes, you're going to have people. And I would, if I had a Cybertruck, I would be doing it not every chance I get, but I would be wanting to play with its incredible horsepower and acceleration in a safe environment when no one's around me. But would I be doing it in traffic? Of course, you're asking for trouble at that point. And that is up to the driver, not the Cybertruck. Cybertruck, you know, it's been getting a lot of crap. I gave it a lot of crap, but I'm here to defend it and its safety. Also, you guys down below, if you enjoyed it, again, hit the like button. Make sure you're subscribed. If you would like me to test a Cybertruck one day on the channel, I don't know why. I mean, it's already been tested. People already know pretty much the gist of it. But if you guys would like it on the channel or Tesla's on the channel, let me know. If you want me to review a Tesla, which I haven't done, I've driven them before, but I haven't reviewed one. So if you want me to go rent one on Turo or something, let me know. And I can do that for you guys here on the channel. But thanks for watching. See you in the comment section. Long live the Cybertruck. Long live bigger, stronger, faster here in America. Bigger is better, right? It's built in Texas. So I got to cut myself off. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.